Hello, my name's Simon Room. I'm the Broadcast Sales Manager for Synthax Audio UK. In today's video, we're going to be taking a look at Calrec's Panel Designer software. So one of the great things about Calrec's Type R console is its versatility. In previous videos, we've had a look at how the control surface can be reconfigured. We've looked at how we can select different layouts of fader panels and how you can have different layouts of the soft panels. In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can actually change what appears on the soft panels. The design that you see on a soft panel is called a layout. You're free to change the configuration of that layout, so you can change the functions of the buttons and the encoders you see there. You can also change the orientation, so it can either be in a portrait layout or it could be in a landscape layout. If you've got more than one panel, there's no obligation to have the same design on each panel, so each panel can look different. And also, you can change how the panel is displayed depending on the snapshot that's loaded as well. When you get the Type R out of the box, you'll find there's already some layouts loaded into the core, ready to be loaded onto the soft panels. These may be all the panel designs that you need. What's much more likely is that you'll want to either modify one of these designs or create your own so that you can build the panels to suit your environment. So Panel Designer is a piece of software that loads onto a PC. It allows you to open up the layout, it allows you to edit it, and it allows you to save it. So it's ready to be loaded back into the console when you're next connected. Panel Designer allows you to change the complexity of the layout depending on the operator that's going to be using the console. So for an operator that is a DJ or that is a comedian or a presenter, they'll need something that's relatively simple. Timers, clocks, these kind of things. They won't need a full-on production setup. If somebody is a sound engineer, you can build a much more complicated panel that includes EQs and dynamic controls. We can also add a little bit of branding in there. So you'll see that in the top corner of the screen, there is a block where you can put your own logo or the station logo. If a DJ from a particular station comes up, opens the desk up, then we will see that station ident sitting on the top of the screen. Of course, this means that the console can be used for multiple stations, each station having its own snapshot it can load, and the branding appears with that snapshot. The Panel Designer software works offline, so you don't need to be connected to the console when you're creating designs. However, at some point you are going to need to connect to the console because you'll have to load from Designer into the core in order to be able to load it onto a panel. Of course, the great thing about Type R is you don't actually have to be in the same room, you don't have to be in the same location even. Type R works really well remotely, so we can work with Panel Designer remotely. We can set up our remote connection into the console and we can load the new layout down to the console over that remote link. So let's just open Panel Designer up and have a go at creating a simple layout. So I've already installed Panel Designer and opened it up. And we can see we can either edit one of the existing designs or we can create a brand new one. When we create a brand new one, we want to do it as a complete new design. Give it a name, save it, and there we go, we're ready to design. We can select whether we want a large screen or a small screen. We can decide the orientation of the panel as it's actually going to be operated. Once we've made those decisions, we see the grid of all the blocks that we can use and we can fill with the controls we need. So Designer shows you the layout of the screen as it will appear. In this case, with the large panel, we have 6x3 touch blocks, and we can fill those with the functions, with the controls we need. We click on any particular block. We either click the new or we double click. It opens up and you can see there's a whole range of controls that we can put in that block. For instance, I can select a button. I can load it. We've now assigned that touch block as a button. What sort of button? Well, we double click, we open up, and here's where we choose the function that is going to be assigned to that button. So once you decide the function, we can load it up, we can apply it, and it appears on the panel. If we change our minds, if we want to move where that button appears, we can just click and drag If we decide it was a mistake, we don't want it, then we can just clear that button off. Some of the controls you can choose use more than one single touch block. For instance, we can look at something like an EQ display. As we go to choose the function, on the right-hand side of the screen here, we can actually see how big it's going to appear once we load it. So for instance, the large EQ curve will take up half of the touch screen. If you decide to use large blocks, then you're very quickly going to run out of screen space. But that's not a problem because you can add multiple tabs to the screen. So as well as a button or a display, there's a wide range of other functions that we can put onto those blocks. So it could be, for instance, a rotary control. We can add in clocks. We can also add in timers. So if your operator needs a timer to see how long they've been talking for, very simple to add a timer to the screen. There is quite a wide range of options, including meters, including displays, as we've already seen. So as you add functions to a screen, one nice feature is that you can change the labeling. So for instance, you can pick a control. You can assign it to something relatively complicated. Let's assign a talkback button. And let's perhaps give the operator the option to talk back to the engineer in the control room. Now, when the button appears, you see it's got quite a long, complicated label, which the operator may not fully understand. So what we can do is we can very easily change that. So now we've got something the operator will definitely understand. So let's have a quick look at how we would build a small, simple panel for an operator. So I'm going to select one of the small soft panels. I'm going to give them a clock so that they can keep an eye on time. Let's put in a simple, small clock. I think it would also be good to give them an indication of the fact that they are broadcasting, so we'll put the on-air controls on as well. Now, because this is for an operator, maybe it'd be nice for them to have something like a cough button. So let's add in a button control, a single button. We'll make it nice and easy to use. And that button, let's say it's going to be a cough button, so we're going to need to take a fader control. I'm going to need to take that fader cut. And what I'm also going to do, we're now going to change the labeling so that the operator knows what it is. We're just going to make it nice and simple. And we're going to call it the cough button. Straight away we can see the cough button's appeared. And also let's give the operator the option to talk back to the engineer. Once again, nice, simple, single button. In that button, we want to make that the operator's talk back. And we want to be able to let the operator talk back to the control room, to the guy on the other side of the glass. But once again, we want to make it a nice simple button, something that they can easily understand. So there we go. The operator has now got an idea of what the time is. They've got an idea of the fact that they're on air. They've got some nice simple cough and talk controls. And because this is a talk show would have been a bit of music. There's a DJ, the DJ is going to be talking. Let's give the DJ a timer as well. Let's get it to run off the fader. Let's use a single block. So now we've got a fader timer, but we want to make it specifically for the DJ. So what we're going to do is we're going to assign it to a particular fader. for the purposes of this, the DJ's fader is fader number one on layer A, but we are saying that this timer in front of the DJ will be specific for him. Add a logo in so that we know station that's being used. So here we go. So now we've got a basic panel ready for the DJ. So the next thing we'd like to see is how we get it from panel designer into the panel. So this design operation can be done when not connected to the console or when connected, but at a later date when you do connect, you can then transfer the panel across. And of course the Type R very much lends itself to remote operation. So I don't even have to be in the same room to connect to the console. This can be connected remotely to a console that's in a completely different building. All I need to do is set up that link so I can establish a connection between the two. Okay, so in this case, we've already done that. So now I've saved the design. I'll go back to my list of designs. So to get it out of the software, we use the export function. Now, in order to get it into the console, this is where we do need to establish connection to the console. So I've already done that, and I'm going to take a look at Calrec Assist. Okay, we've got Connect open. We can now go and look at the panel layouts. These are obviously the ones already loaded in, but I want to add the one I've just created. So I'm now going to import, and import brings it from the computer into the Type R core. So Assist is really just looking at all the panel designs, all the layouts that are already loaded into the core. So let's choose the file we want. It's obviously the new one on the desktop. Okay, so that is now loaded in. And if we look down, we should find new layout. So we can see the layout we just created in the console. And of course it was a design for a small panel. So I'm going to select the small panel that's connected to the console. Click the apply button. And there we go. The design has loaded already. So it's that quick from creating to bringing it into the console to actually having that design running on the soft panel. So in conclusion, the option to change the layouts on the panel is what makes the Type R so versatile. I hope this video has given you a little flavour of what's possible. But if you want to know more, then please get in touch with Synthax Audio. We'd be very happy to give you a demo of the software, to give you a demo of the console.